One-on-one with Saudi Arabia's foreign minister. We'll get the latest reaction on the tensions with Iran in a brand new CNN interview. Plus, week 16 of mass protests in Hong Kong as police face new allegations of brutality. We'll have more on the ground from the protests. Plus, it's been described as the largest climate change protest in history. Organizers say millions of young people marched in cities around the world as youth activists descend on the United Nations today. We're going to have a live report on what's happening there from New York. Hello, I'm Lynda Kinkade. Welcome to CNN Newsroom. The United States says it does not seek conflict with Iran, but it is sending in more troops to the Middle East in response to what it calls a dramatic escalation of Iranian aggression. U.S. officials say the troops will be focused on air and missile defense in Saudi Arabia and the United Arab Emirates following last week's attack on Saudi oil production facilities. Both the United States and Saudi Arabia blame Iran for last week's oil production attacks. Saudi Foreign Minister Abdel Al-Jaber says that once investigators uncover proof of Iran's responsibility, the Saudi government will, in his words, take appropriate measures. Al-Jaber sat down with our international diplomatic editor, Nick Robertson.
Are we on the threshold of a military response, do you believe?
We don't want war. The U.S. doesn't want war. But it's really up to the Iranians. If they keep continuing along this path, then they risk the possibility of military action. But nobody wants war. Everybody wants to resolve this peacefully. And the end result has to be an end to Iran's aggressive policies.
I don't see the difference at the moment, if you don't mind me saying, of Iran producing these weapons and then waiting for an investigation to find out where they were fired from, because surely it all amounts to the same thing, that you're going to come to the same point. Eventually, are you playing for time by saying that we're investigating right now when you perhaps have a very strong inclination?
No, we hold Iran responsible because the missiles and the drones that were fired at Saudi Arabia, not only against Gaik and Horais, but also from Yemen, were Iranian-built and Iranian-delivered missiles. So we hold them responsible. But to launch an attack from your territory, if that is the case, puts it in a different category.
What's the different category?
This would be considered an act of war.
Pretty strong words there. We're going to have more from Nick Robertson's interview with the Saudi foreign minister coming up next hour on CNN. Well, Iran also faces new U.S. economic sanctions. It continues, though, to deny that it was responsible for last week's attack on Saudi Arabia. Our Nick Paton Walsh reports from Tehran.
Iran's Revolutionary Guard Corps said this day that they would shoot down any drone in Iranian airspace. Frankly, standing policy, really, and perhaps contributing, according to Iranian officials, to the incident a few months ago where a U.S. drone was shot down, although the U.S. insists that was over international waters. But also a response from the Iranian foreign minister about sanctions announced just 24 hours ago by Donald Trump, the U.S. president, against the Central Bank of Iran and its sovereign wealth fund. Now, well, Donald Trump said that these were historic, the worst sanctions any nation's faced. The particular moves he just took aren't actually that serious. The central bank is already under sanctions, part of those reinstated when Trump pulled out of the nuclear deal. And the sovereign wealth fund, well, that hasn't been sanctioned before, but even the Treasury's press release said $5 billion were taken out of it roughly in January of this year. So it's likely both of these institutions, Iranian officials have been aware, are under U.S. crosshairs potentially. They've been designated as assisting terrorist groups, which makes them toxic, certainly, and it'd be very hard to remove that designation for future administrations in the U.S. going forwards. But the actual impact they'll have, according to most analysts I've spoken, is reasonably slight, although Iran's foreign minister pointed out the central bank is seminal to foreign exchange transactions, and that could impede Iran's ability to get humanitarian aid into the country. He also reiterated his thesis that there are hawks around Donald Trump who are trying, in fact, to push him into some kind of military confrontation with Iran. But that still seems distant at this point. Donald Trump saying that he felt he was being cautious, he was being restrained, he was being strong by deciding not to take military action. Instead, there will be potentially more U.S. troops assisting Saudi Arabia's defenses. And diplomacy may now see some kind of moment in New York at the U.N. General Assembly in the days ahead. The Iranian foreign minister is on his way there, may have already arrived, and on Monday. He'll be joined by the Iranian President Hassan Rouhani. They've said they won't talk to the United States directly unless sanctions were reimposed when Trump pulled out of the nuclear deal are lifted again. But they might talk with Saudi Arabia or the United Arab Emirates or other nations that could potentially ease tension in this area, which seem now to be ebbing, perhaps with the overall question of quite what this means for the balance of power in the Middle East, given the direct accusations against Iran by the US and Saudi Arabia, and how at this point the retaliation has been mostly through economic measures. Nick Paton Walsh, CNN, Tehran.